Welcome to Black Forest Lutheran Church. My name is Pastor Ken Hoheg. Thank you for being here to celebrate the life of Keith Knutson and to be here to support his family. That is a high gift. Just so I can see, who is family and extended family? Raise your hand. Yeah, just a small group. Just a small group. How many of you are from Synthes or whatever you call that company? Great, great. Thanks for being here. And how many of you are friends of the family? Yeah. Thank you. Yes. What's that? All of us. Yes. Thank you so much. I invite you to take your red hymnals, turn to the front part, page 279. Please stand. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the source of all mercy, the God of all consolation. He comforts us in our sorrows so that we can comfort others in their sorrows with the consolation we ourselves have received from God. When we were baptized into Christ, we were baptized into his death. We were buried, therefore, with him by baptism into death, so that as Christ was raised by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we shall certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. The hymn is in the back of your hymnal, 779. God of grace and glory, we remember before you today our brother Keith. We thank you for giving him to us to know and to love as a companion in our pilgrimage on earth. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us faith to see that death has been swallowed up in the victory of our Lord Jesus Christ, so that we may live in confidence and hope until by your call we are gathered to our heavenly home in the company of all your saints, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Please be seated. The family has chosen a number of hymns and a number of readings, and the first is from Psalm 46. Psalm 46 is the basis for a hymn some of you may know. It's called A Mighty Fortress. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth should change, though the mountains shake in the heart of the sea, though its waters roar and foam, though the mountains tremble in its tumult. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. He says, be still and know that I am God. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. In your bulletin, you'll notice on the right-hand side is printed Psalm 91, assorted verses. I invite you to read this with me. You who live in the shelter of the Most High, who abide in the shadow of the Almighty, will say to the Lord, my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust. For he will command his angels concerning you to guard you in all your ways. On their hands they will bear you up so that you do not dash your foot against a stone. Those who love me I will deliver. I will protect those who know my name. When they call to me, I will answer them. I will be with them in trouble. I will rescue them and honor them. With long life, I will satisfy them and show them my salvation.
Well, it's good to see the state of North Dakota here in half a centies. Bear with me as I try to get through this. I want to take a minute and thank all the family, friends, colleagues for coming together as we celebrate our father. I'm Jesse, I'm the third out of four boys. It's an honor to stand here and share these final thoughts with you. Our father was the rock of the family. He never wavered raising four boys, and he never once was his love for us ever questioned. He was tough as nails, but had a heart so strong, nobody would deny it. Growing up, we quickly realized that dad was a master with his hands and a genius with his mind. We were building the addition for the house strictly off of his knowledge, and my older brother Casey quickly realized how scared of heights he was when dad made a Norwegian 4x4 with the pump jack scaffolding and he dropped 20 feet with no control. No lie, you should have seen that face. We will leave his kind words of choice for another day, but damn, was that funny. And Dad and Mom both got a big chuckle out of it. There wasn't anything Dad could do or was afraid of tackling, regardless if it came with instructions or not. He never used them. Well, until we got to the point where we were stuck, and then those directions came in really handy. We listened to stories about Dad over the past couple of weeks, and they're uncanny. His love for everybody was strong, and he loved everyone very much. However, all we can do is smile and laugh at his humor, because without it, we wouldn't be the men we are today. Dad was so in love with Dad was so in love with Mom that he couldn't live without her. That's a good jam. Those two were like swans. It didn't matter the weather, they were always going to be together. There are two things in life that are absolute. Love is forever and life is temporary. Dad proved that every day he was alive. There wasn't a stronger love in the world other than those two being together. We will miss him every day of our lives, and we pray over time their hearts will heal and our family can bond together. We're going to miss you, Dad. We're going to miss you more than you can imagine, but we're going to continue to grow as a family and move forward. Thank you for your time and being here. I appreciate it, and so does the family.
From 1 Corinthians chapter 13, love is patient, kind. Love is not envious, boastful, arrogant, or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. Love does not rejoice at the wrong, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. I invite you to look at the back of your bulletin. Keith was born to Irving and Lois Knutson October 22, 1954. His family lived in Christine, North Dakota, then moved to Fargo, where Keith met his childhood sweetheart, Robin Ann Thompson, 1969. Anybody know where Fargo is? Couple? Something about the Red River? Keith grew up with four brothers and one sister. His brother Rod was fond of memories of a band they formed calling the Midget Monkeys. His sister-in-law Evelyn remembers the 20th Street Gang they all formed with their siblings and cousins in the early teens. They all enjoyed swimming together in the Red River and rode banana seat bikes around town. Kids, you don't peel those. It's a big seat. According to his siblings, Keith always liked to make things work. When he and his brother Rod found an old wooden wagon, they tried to fix it and ride it down a hill. They got about a quarter way down the hill before it fell apart. Keith could also be mischievous, like the time he stole 12-year-old Robin's bike to get her attention. Keith loved the outdoors. He played quite a few sports in Fargo, including football in the streets, softball, and tennis. With so much family around, Keith could always be found with his siblings, his cousins, and Robin's family, riding bikes, camping, shooting arrows, canoe trips, backgammon tournaments. They also hung out at the old abandoned semi-trucks, which they turned into forts. In his teen years, Keith worked the Imperial Preserves in Fargo, aka Paul Mark and the Jelly Factory, along with his siblings and cousins. The Knutson vacations in Keith's childhood were often short weekend trips to the family farm, where Keith said were more work than vacation. Their family reunions were held at Red Willow Resort near the farm, which had a small lake with boats, fishing, softball, and an indoor roller skating rink with wooden floors. Keith learned how to roller skate forward and backward when he was about 9 or 10 years old. Years later, when he went skating with Robin at Bud's skating rink in Moorhead, Minnesota, she was very impressed. They spent the whole evening skate dancing to every song. Keith married Robin Thompson on December 14, 1974. They moved from Fargo to here, Colorado Springs, in 1982. Keith was smart, level-headed, steady as a rock. That proved to be a strong quality as he started and raised his own family with Robin. Together they had four sons, Dustin, Casey, Jess, and Charlie. In 1986, Keith began his 33-year career at Synthes as a machinist. He attended college in the evenings for computer science. In the early 90s, he was promoted to manager of the IT department. He received several awards for outstanding service and loyalty to Synthes throughout the years. He always cared about his coworkers. One of his colleagues recently said, "Keith was a lifelong friend and the best boss I ever had." After their sons grew up, Keith and Robin enjoyed traveling to Niagara Falls, Germany, Ireland, Hawaii, Mexico, Jamaica, Austria, Switzerland, Canada, and many road trips across the country. He was an avid golfer, very competitive, and he taught his sons and three grandsons, Tristan, Cody, and Liam, to golf. He was especially proud when Tristan won the 2020 Grant Open, the first Knutson to win in 40 years. How many know what the Grant Open is? Okay, how many attended the Grant Open? It's amazing, the same people. In his final game, just before he passed, Keith mud-stomped his youngest... Mud-stomp
means? Stomped him into the ground.
He stomped him into the ground. All right, he mud-stomped his youngest son, Charlie, with a score of 82-90, leaving no question as to who the true champion was. Being a father of four boys, he also cherished his time with his two granddaughters, Haley and Mason. After Keith retired in 2019, he and Robin spent time camping, gardening, traveling, paddleboarding, golfing, and riding e-bikes. His sons say he was an extreme mountain biker at the age of 68. Keith Irving Knutson passed away July 7th, 2023. Dustin, Casey, Jess, Charlie, friends, family, grace to you and peace from God our Father and from our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. Three words I think of when I think of Keith. You've heard some of them already. Creative, consistent, caring. Creative. Whether it was with that old wooden wagon, fixing it, maybe not fixing it real well that time, all the way to building an addition on the house. Good with his hands. Whether it was cars or plumbing or carpentry, he was creative. And he was consistent, like a what? Rock. And whether that was working a job by day and going to school at night, consistent, focused, step by step, like a rock with his family. And when Robin was in the hospital, where was Dad? By your side. And when Mom died suddenly, where was Dad? By your side. Like a rock. He too was devastated, but he knew what you needed also. Like a rock. Consistent. And he cared. It's why you picked 1 Corinthians 13. Love is patient. Love is kind. It's not boastful, arrogant, or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It rejoices not in the wrong, but in the right. Kind of sounds like Keith. By the way, here, Keith sat right there. Sunday mornings. Keith was not perfect. None of us are. But in his creativity, consistency, and care, he reflects his Lord and Savior. We hear it, we're going to hear it a bit in our song. He's the creator. He's the one who made those mountains that we see. He's the one who made the stars in the sky. Or last night, did you see the sunset? After the rain, maybe during the rain, clouds, and then this opening and the shining of the sun coming through with a background of the yellow. All the way from there to your mom's sunflowers, reminding us of the sun. And then in the inside, all those seeds arranged in a perfect spiral. Keith reflected God's own creativity. The Lord is also consistent, present, like a rock. Psalm 46, God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in times of trouble. Therefore, we will not fear though the earth should change, though the mountains shake in the heart of the sea. And in fact, that is what's happened. We were here a year ago putting to rest Robin. And now, suddenly, we find ourselves doing the same with Keith. Your lives shaken to the very foundation. You have a rock still. You saw reflected in your father the kind of consistency and strength and commitment that he knew in his Lord. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help. Now, tomorrow, next week, next month, next year. Even the earth should change. Even the mountains might shake in the depths of the sea. And then the Lord says to all of us, because I'm your rock, because I am your refuge, because I am with you, be still. Be still and know that I am your God. You're not God. I am. I've got you. I hold you in the palm of my hand. And why does he do such things? Because the Lord cares. We see that reflected also in your dad. When we hear 1 Corinthians 13, we focus on love, which is appropriate. The interesting thing is if you substitute the word love and put God, the Lord, Jesus, in there, it makes perfect sense. The Lord is patient and kind. The Lord is not jealous or boastful, arrogant, or rude. He doesn't insist on his own way. Come on, let's be real, right? In your life, he doesn't insist on his own way. He keeps going, come, follow me. Come, know me. Come, know how good I am. But he doesn't insist on it. He lets us wander and go wherever we want. He doesn't insist on his own way. No, he bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Even though the earth should change, even though the mountains shake in the depths of the sea, even though our very hearts are shaken, God is our refuge. He is our strength, our rock. You do not walk alone. In the song that we will sing, we hear it again. You who dwell in the shelter of the Lord, who abide in his shadow for life, will say to the Lord, my refuge, my rock in whom I trust. Funerals are something I never turn down. Weddings, they're fun, they're great, but funerals, when people gather with questions and with hurt and with an emptiness inside, there we need to hear a word of hope. My God, in whom I trust. I invite you to turn to the hymn and sing.
Breath.
I invite you to turn again to the front part of your hymnals, page 282. For about 2,000 years, Christian people have been gathering, generally on Sundays, to remember that Jesus rose from the dead on a Sunday. And they asked questions, especially things like, well, who is Jesus? And they found answers, and those early on were put together, and it forms the words of the Apostles' Creed. Let us confess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who is conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. As we pray, I will conclude each prayer with the words, Lord, in your mercy. And I invite you to respond, hear our prayer. Let's practice. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
You got it. Almighty God, you have knit your chosen people together into one family, the body of your Son, Jesus Christ. Give to your whole church in heaven and on earth your light and your peace. Lord, in your mercy. Hear our prayer. Grant to all who are baptized into Christ's death and resurrection, may die to sin and rise to new life, that through the gate and grave of death, we may pass with him, Jesus, to our joyful resurrection. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Grant to your faithful people pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from our sin and serve you with a quiet mind. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Grant to us all who mourn a sure confidence of your loving care, that casting all our sorrow on you, we may know the consolation of your love. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Give courage and faith to all who grieve, that they may have the strength to meet the days ahead in comfort of a holy and certain hope and in the joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Grant us grace to entrust Keith to your never-failing love which sustained him in his life. Receive him into the arms of your mercy. Remember him according to the favor you bear for your people. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
God of grace, you sent your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior, to bring us hope and life. We give you thanks that because of his death, Jesus destroyed the power of death, and by his resurrection has opened the kingdom of heaven to all who believe. Make us certain that because he lives, we will live also, and that neither death nor life, nor things present nor things to come, will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. I invite you to join me in praying the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. forever and ever. Amen. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant, Keith. Acknowledge, we ask, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive him into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. Receive the benediction. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Having a gathering kitty corner from here at the Black Forest Community Center. You are invited to come. There is something to eat, there is something to see, there's something to drink. So please do. Often we end our services, I say something, you say something. I say, go in peace, serve the Lord, and then you will say, thanks be to God. Got it? You say, thanks be to God. Jess, you're going to say, thanks be to God. Got it?
I got you.
Okay. Yeah. Go in peace, serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.